All right, that looks good. Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Little Witch Nobetta. We took a week off thanks to me having no voice for a week. You know, yeah, I know. Makes it hard to stream. I am your host, Vincent.
I am the Krampus.
And I'm Hunter Green.
And I'm Vincent. Sorry, I'm just used to going lost too much.
So I just did a sound check. You might want to lower the audio coming from Discord if you can, or at the very least lower Krampus and I. We are coming in very loud.
You two are coming in very loud. Let me...
We are very loud.
Yeah, that is probably Discord. Let me see if this works. Okay, guys, say something.
Gee willikers, the church sure is evil.
Ooh, woo.
Okay, how's that?
We're still a little louder compared to you, but we're not as bad as we were.
Okay.
We were almost ear-splitting.
Got it. A little bit more, but... One of these two Discords. Okay. Yeah, because you guys are basically just captured desktop audio.
But yeah.
I can just lower Discord itself. Okay. So yes. So when we last left off, we're going through this place. Realizing that the lore items are basically the church is evil and stuff, let's briefly go over a lot of the new stuff. I mean, really briefly. Blah, 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 blah. Victor Bell, da, da, da. Beggars explore the ancient ruins, search for valuable materials, turn to simple coins. They unexpectedly uncover the lost technology of crafted souls, which they attributed to God's will. Oh my god, something new. Can we get... blah blah, world has heroes. Crafted soul turn into creatures of demonic appearance. When this happened, the church granted them mercy and their suffering. That page, and that's all that stuff. Okay. Hey, Case. We're about to enter the second section of these, basically, sniper duels via lightning. Starting with moving around this corner. And into this.
You work with what you got.
Yeah. Thankfully, they're not immune to friendly fire. Ow.
As none should be.
Sniping! Sure, something down there. Anyways.
All the Pontiff Sector.
This certainly isn't something about how the church is evil or something.
I mean, to be fair, can we have a single game where the church isn't blatantly evil in some way? Not every game needs to be hyper-realistic, okay?
Oh. As you can see, that's the most dangerous thing up here. I did not know you could teleport. Knock it off.
God love the friendliest of fire.
Yep. Sometimes it's just easier to let them do the work for you. Okay.
Divine intervention.
Damn it. Cleared this out of most enemies. Not all of them. This is a largely empty area of just field of enemies. Cursed stamina. Alright. Not sure what I'm being so paranoid about. I know what's up here. Candles. The throne.
The throne.
Our objective, which means we're going to ignore it for a while. Okay, so mainly that's what I was getting, we're trying to get to.
You said haste only goes to 20, unlike other stuff, or?
30. Everything else goes 30. To 99, but haste only goes to 30.
I was partially correct.
Look, a door!
Secret boss or something, or
it's actually an entire secret dungeon, but
secret dungeon. Behind the paper mache wall, you know the there.
Oh, fuck. There you are. Thank you. Okay. They're not even trying. Ice!
More ice!
Yep. Our missiles, max targets, boost defense. Same shtick. Oh, that looks safe.
Yeah, a spiral staircase with no railing, probably full of enemies. Snipers shooting down at you. What's not to like?
So the biggest irony is this area was actually designed before the previous one we just did. This was actually the last area in the demo.
Ah.
And the previous area wasn't actually in the demo. There we go, got it. All right. Aha, parry. That mechanic I created exists except when it actually happens. Welcome to the dumbest EXP area in the game.
Is it just blatantly here for farming, or is there some kind of, like, reasonable challenge to it?
It's kind of neither. It's more just, like, a little oversight when you two mechanics interact with each other. So... he's just there. There's also more enemies down this way, so you can actually just do all that, then return to Goddess Statue, because there's no penalty for that.
Right.
And it will respawn everything.
So in Soulsian fashion, this is a good bonfire to grind at.
Basically, yeah.
I see. I don't necessarily have a problem with that. There's a place like that in every Dark Souls game, where either by intent or by coincidence, just a good place to do over and over.
Yeah, basically.
I mean, my Dark Souls 2 and 3 knowledge are limited, but I definitely did that in the first, like, little town area in Dark Souls 1. There was that bonfire that was inside the little tower. And the area around it was just good eats for a low-level character.
Yep. Yep, welcome to the first part of the game. It's where it indirectly reconnects, basically.
Yeah.
Ah.
Except that part. Say turn up here. I do remember it being something. No, I suppose not. Is this this one? It was that way. Ah, half-elf's mana ring.
The one thing I will say in this game, it's kind of samey all the way through.
Yeah.
I mean, you have the occasional foray into the hot zone, dark zone. I think there was a cold zone. Am I remembering that correctly, or am I just...
No, there was a
transposing
cave, but...
from another video game. Regular cave, not cold cave.
Yeah.
Red crystal cave. I remember that. But it just kind of is the same, like, texture all the way through.
A little bit of that. I mean, the enemies are very samey.
Yeah, the enemies are all generic blobs. Now, this isn't, like, a cardinal sin. I'm not saying, oh, it all looks the same. This game is terrible. because obviously this game was made by an indie team with access to not as many resources, and they made do with what they had.
Yeah. It's also
not, it does.
It's also not that long, which is the other thing.
Yeah, that's the other thing. If this lasted for a lot longer but had the same graphics all the way through, it'd be a lot more noticeable and a lot less interesting.
Yeah. Go ahead.
For a game as long as this is, it can get away with having the samey kind of Unity background. It's not attractive. I was originally going to ask how much this game was, but honestly,
I don't think
that matters as much for the argument.
No.
Like, I'm assuming this game was not a $60 game.
No.
I'm assuming this was like a $20, $30 game.
I think it was more in the 20 range.
Okay. Like, if you ask me $29.99 for a game like this, I'd say that's worth it.
I would have to look at the store page to remember what the exact price was.
Yeah. Like I said, that's not a huge thing.
So the main thing about this dungeon is a lot of books. Elemental books.
Ah.
Ah, unlimited midair dodge.
Oh, nice. Give yourself infinite dodge.
Ah, friendly fire. Ah, crap. Run away, that's fine. Be noted, resting at the statue will also kill the guy nearby. What do I actually want to do with this? Aha! More fire. Remember, that one's more interesting. That increases area of fireball explosion.
Dear kaboom!
There was supposed to be an earth-shattering kaboom. Marvin the Martian. Known enemy of Martian Man.
That was indeed a thing that happened.
I'm gonna be honest, the two best of those, in my opinion, were Marvin the Martian and the Martian Manhunter, and the one that was better than it had any right to be between Batman and Batman.
Yeah. That part weirded me out, too.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah, so, to set the stage here, Warner Brothers, once they, I think they own DC now?
They own DC.
They own DC, yeah. They've owned DC for a while.
Yeah, so they did a series of crossover comics between Looney Tunes slash other properties that Warner Brothers owns, and the DC Universe. And this, there were a lot of these crossovers. There was Sylvester and Tweety and Black Canary and Catwoman, which was also a stealth crossover with Witch Hazel. There was the Banana Splits and the Suicide Squad. But there were also some ones that were legitimately actually pretty good, in my opinion. And two of those were Marvin the Martian versus the Martian Manhunter, where Marvin the Martian is trying to blow up the planet as usual. And the Martian Manhunter goes to stop him. And they end up having this, like, philosophical debate about Earth and humans. And how, like, at some point every Martian, like, goes Earth crazy. And says, like, man, isn't Earth neat? And then they realize the horrible truth that Earth is kind of a shitty planet. Full of shitty people.
I mean, that's not why Marvin Martian wanted to destroy the Earth.
No,
he hated
it
because
it
obstructed his fucking view of Venus.
Yes, that's why he's doing it in the comic, too. He wants to do a Venus. He's going to blow up the planet. But couched within him trying to blow up the planet so he can get a better view of Venus is him having this discussion with the Martian Manhunter.
Yeah, sorry, I don't buy it, Marvin. Fuck that.
Yep. Now, that's the appetite. That was the one that was, okay, this is pretty interesting. So, one of the teams got the job of doing Elmer Fudd and Batman.
All right, that one.
And so, how they did this was Elmer Fudd was, first of all the Warner Brothers Looney Tunes characters were humanized. They're human versions of their their characters. And they're all lunatics of some brand that live in Gotham and are like criminals, crooks, and whatnot, gimmicks. And Elmer Fudd thinks his wife is dead and that Bugs killed her. So he's going to kill Bugs Bunny. And before Elmer shoots him, Bugs claims that he was hired to do it by Bruce Wayne. And so Elmer Fudd gets it in his head he's going to take a double barrel shotgun into the latest Wayne gala and murder Bruce Wayne. And so, of course, Bruce Wayne's not going to take that, so he goes to Batman, hunts Elmer Fudd back down to his apartment, and it's played completely straight. Bud still has the accent. All the Looney Tunes characters say their iconic lines, but somehow they pitch perfect wrote this book so that everybody's saying these, you know, really ridiculous things, but they're still in character and they feel like they belong in a Batman. And even Elmer Fudd gets to outsmart Batman a little bit in a couple of scenes. And they quickly realize they're getting played, so then Elmer Fudd and Batman team up and go try and hunt down Bugs. And spoilers for the book. It turns out that Elmer Fudd's wife isn't dead. Elmer Fudd's wife is a minor love interest from the Silver Age of Batman, who, after dating Batman, dated Elmer Fudd, then realized he was the same brand of crazy that Bruce Wayne was because she knew Bruce Wayne was Batman. And so she faked her death and had Bugs say it was Bruce Wayne. Because she knew that Bruce Wayne could take care of himself and defeat any kind of assassin, and then the trail would go cold. And the book ends with her walking out on all of them and going to start a new life, and all of them sitting at the bar and ordering carrot juice with Bugs. It's amazing. And I don't even mean amazing in an ironic, like, oh my god, look at this shit kind of way. I mean, they were given a ridiculous assignment and they made a Oh, and the best part is it affects Batman canon. It actually affects Batman canon going forward.
What?
In a very minor way. The bar that they go to is Porky's Bar. And various artists and writers have since used Porky's Bar, which did not exist in Gotham before this, as a location in their books. They don't use any of the Warner Brothers characters. Elmer Fudd is not mentioned by name. They don't reference that time Batman fought a guy with a penchant for double barrel shotguns and speech impediment. But Porky's does appear in the series. And so it does, in its own small way, affect canon. And I love that.
That disturbs me. So many levels.
Like, legitimately, like, okay, we're gonna be real here. You know where you would theoretically read a comic book if you wanted to read a comic book.
Yes.
I believe that, to leave you to fill in what that location is. I do honestly recommend that you check out Elmer Fudd vs. Batman.
All right, off topic, and but poignant for tonight. So, you guys know who Markiplier is, right?
I'm aware of who Markiplier is, yes.
Yeah.
Did you know what he did tonight?
No.
He created an OnlyFans page and brought down the site.
Oh, yeah, because he lost a bet.
Yep. Oh, phenomenal.
This looks perfectly normal. Certainly nothing going on
new
here.
Boss. New boss?
New boss, who dis?
The orb.
The orb doesn't judge, it only hates. Let's see something.
To be fair, most orbs, they hate. He wants none of that. He just like, nope, don't care.
Whoa.
I'm going to say that's not his.
Yeah, definitely does not pierce his shield like he did last time.
No, the slow blade pierces his
shield. Alright.
Get right.
I'm assuming these are just enraged versions of at least one former boss, probably multiple former bosses?
Just that one.
Just the one, got it. More merciful than I expected.
but sure are things.
Exclusively from the front. Did they do some kind of invisible stuff where he also blocks upwards, quote-unquote, so you can't, like, shock him?
As far as I can tell, no, it is literally physically the shield. They're actually pretty good about that, in general. Unlike previous runs back to bosses, at least these enemies are easy to dodge. Just wish it was shorter.
Yeah.
Thank you. A lot of fancy effects. There we go.
There we go. I do still wonder, as I did before, if due to the number of projectiles it fires, the ice isn't better than the lightning?
Possibly. It's more just how,
Well, that and the ice doesn't need to be for nearly as long.
Let's see. It's more a matter of damage. The AoE on that was, like, I think it took, like, 4 or 5 of those to kill him total.
That's true. I am only thinking of single target when I say that. I'm not thinking of groups of enemies or stuff like that.
As far as, like, single targeting him, the ice might have been better, but again, trying to get around that shield's a pain. And it is a lot easier done with the effectively single rifle that is lightning. I guess our reward for that one is we get to teleport.
Yeah. Nice. Teleport between shrines or just teleport?
Yeah, between goddess statues.
Ah.
Lightning! This was originally where you actually got lightning.
Oh.
Or thunder.
Nice.
Yeah. Level 2. You now go faster. Let's see. Blah blah blah, church, okay, not interesting. Closer to maxing that out. As far as I can tell, at this point in the game would be the point where you'd basically go scurrying around the castle trying to find all the books, slash look them up in a guide to figure out what you missed or whatever. Right. With that said, I've gotten all the books already, so there's not really much else for us to do other than go after the boss of the castle.
He says he's already got them.
So let's go to this point of no return. Oh wait, no, sorry, there's one other thing I completely forgot about. Right, let's do that thing we can't do until the point of no return. Alright. This thing I ignored earlier. Damage difference. Dodge that, but I'll take it. Expecting. Are you fucking kidding me? Thanks, game.
Ah.
is. There it is.
For a non-boss enemy, they should have got a lot of health.
It's effectively a boss. Thank you. three off, that's why.
Yeah, that seems like bullshit.
Yep.
Yeah, I felt like I was in the middle of the dodge there, but whatever. Didn't help that I didn't recover when I wanted to recover there. Instead, use some other random item.
It is nice that that explosion follows him, so he hops in the middle of the explosion.
Yeah, it's one of the first. It's like one of the best level ups, actually. Because before that, it's just stationary. Well, that sucked. What's the point of doing this? Bag expansion.
A little underwhelming, but still useful at least.
Yeah.
It's not like we did that just for like one of the lore items or something, because that would have been bullshit.
Yeah. Da da da, bring the new commander rose, da da. Something else, but I can't find it. I also got a lot of the elven stuff. Elves or elves? Okay. And now we're down here. Come on. Where was the stairs? Over there. Right. Might literally speedrun through this area. Statue, ultimate OP weapon. Okay, now that we've done everything... let's go to the throne.
この玉座を目指してやってきたのですね。あなたは。私もです。君と同じですよ。玉座の力を求めここまで来ました。 他の何事にも目もくれず。ただしかし、なぜでしょう。やっとの思いでここまでたどり着いたというのに。玉座についても、何も、なぜでしょう。
You try a wine glass.
入ってくるはずの力が少しも感じられません。私にはわかります。君はここにいる人間たちとは違う。体を変えれば力を手に入れられるのかしら。
No, spears for years.
Oh, that's nothing.
Spears for days.
Thank you. a second here on that.
Okay, it's not just me. That's a fucking Keyblade.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, that is definitely a Keyblade.
That one is dodgeball running, but...
So, I know that there's not a duck outfit for her. Is there a sailor suit for her?
Not for... it depends what you define. Because there's that one. So, kind
no,
of...
No, not enough.
Yeah.
I was thinking more like, you know, Donald Duck sailor suit.
Yeah. When you start getting serious. No, not quite. Nope.
Also, sorry if I started this fight. Some stuff has been happening around my apartment that I actually had to answer the door for. Is this the final boss?
No. It is the final boss of the castle, but there's a couple of other stages past it. Okay. Okay, now she's getting serious. Or am I far enough away? Yes, good.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Thank you.
There we go.
Yeah.
Alright.
Easier than the previous two things we fought, actually. Alright. One walking case of stranger danger down.
Eating hearts is now ours.
Ah, cutscene clothing.
Cutscene clothing's been a thing.
Yeah.
I know, I just like important cutscene because she has clothing and is not bare.
It's just a chair. It never really ends. That sounds like a you problem.
やっと戻れた。 この私を封印した玉座に。 今度こそ絶対に渡さない。私は私を取り戻す。
Right. So, welcome to the part of the game I didn't know existed until I beat Vanessa for the first time. Because I was figuring it was like, beat Vanessa, then there'd probably be a second form, and I'd fight that. It's like, no, no, there's actually like, a couple entire stages.
Okay. I was also expecting it to end up throwing.
Yeah.
Yep. I may have, in my Twitch, or in my announcement, that we were streaming, lied to.
Ah.
No, that's not true. Technically, it cannot be a lie. I did not intentionally mislead them.
Embrace the power of just being wrong.
Yep.
Exactly. Grab one of you for no reason. Okay, so, A, this is the spirit realm.
As you do.
Yeah. Obviously, we can't teleport anywhere because this is the only place we have. That was a point of no return. Okay. Of note here, Nabetta actually moves a little bit different. For example, her melee combo is now that. As opposed to, like, the clumsy, waggling about that she does for, like, hits 3 and 4 beforehand.
No, so we've gained the ultimate superpower, confidence.
Yep.
Did we trip anymore?
We still trip, but also,
have a good amount of
the air dodge. Yeah. I remember the trip recovery is a bit faster too. Finally, the barrel is mine.
Oh, the barrel's trapped.
Yep. Blue ones! Who do that?
And who moved?
I was gonna say, oh no, the blue ones gotta go fast. I wonder if this is a reference.
Ow!
Yep.
Your new power means nothing compared to the power of Electric Blue.
I mean, Sonic the Hedgehog is a goo form.
And I'll be stuck. Get tight. All right, let's try this again. Only slightly more intelligent. By that, I mean, I'm gonna hide over here.
I mean, that's intelligent.
Ah, crap. I'm really close to dead.
We're only mildly dying.
Yeah, that's a lot of health in these crystals.
Relatively scathed.
Ah, you're fine. Only amount of HP is that last one. The rest is just, you know, comfort.
Doctor's mask. Is and isn't around here, that's right. Yeah, that thing's far more annoying when you have to headshot it. Which means the last time I was here was a higher level. There's the hole. And the last wind upgrade. Oh,
more wind.
Emergency dodge may be triggered when attacked by an enemy.
Back.
Alright, and you're only back to full. And the main enemies for this area. Knights.
Dreams.
Not gonna lie, they look like I would expect them to be characters Genshin Impact.
I get for trying to be fair. All right.
Why would you ever be fair in a Souls game? Like, even if this is a FromSoft game.
Because I didn't remember the enemy was there.
Ah.
Oh no, Sonic died. I have to step away for a second, but I'll be right back.
That's one of the Night Knights. Those are the bow ones. Generally more manageable.
I return.
Welcome back. Last time. All variants for this area. Kill her at least. Ah, death, the alternate EXP grind.
Thank you.
Ah. Drift it downward. Lightning absolutely has friendly fire. Or just die already. Thank you. Hardly had any health. No game, I do not want to move with me, thank you. Nothing. All right. Quite the view of something. Ah, just what I was looking for. There we go. Mass haste. I'll start working on damage. Alright. This looks like a good place to call it. Considering it's like 11 o'clock right now.
Yep.
Alright. So, with that being said, that's all we have for tonight. Join us next week when we'll probably maybe finish this game. I'm not entirely sure how much of it is left, because I haven't played through all of it yet. I played through everything we have right now, but I haven't played through all of it. In any case, join us on Sunday for more Super Robot Wars V, where we are kind of, sort of, meandering towards the endgame. Join us on Monday for more Pokemon Nuzlocke, Soul Link,
Pain.
Mainly Pain.
Heart Gold, Soul going. Silver.
Yeah.
We lose and gain each day.
Well, you know. I assume there's at least forward progress in the game.
Yes, actually. It's kind of surprising.
That's a type of good, at least. Join us on possibly on Tuesdays now?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Tuesdays for more Fuga, Melodies of Steel.
And a lot more fun than I thought it would be.
That's good. And join us back here on Thursdays for more and possibly final Little Witch Nobeta. Till then, I'm Vincent.
I've been the Krampus.
And I'm Hunter Grain.
And remember, everyone, even winning a fight, you'll get banished to the Spirit Realm.
Spirit Realm all the way down.
Yep.